Little more than 1 week removed from Juwan James' fateful decision to opt out of the 2020 season, the Denver Broncos have signed free agent offensive tackle Demar Dotson to help fill the void. NFL Network's Ian Rappaport broke the news Tuesday evening. We learned from KUSA's Mike Kliss that Dotson's one-year deal is incentive-laden and worth up to $3 million if he hits all the escalators. For what it's worth, that's excellent value for such an experienced tackle. GM John Elway has essentially decided to rent out Dotson's services for one season at a relatively low cost. If Dotson goes on to see serious snaps and plays well, Elway can always circle back and try to re-sign him in 2021. Although the veteran tackle will turn 35 this year and is getting increasingly long in the tooth, guys like Andrew Whitworth in Los Angeles and Jason Peters in Philadelphia are proving that tackles who can fend off the injury bug can play late into their 30s and forestall the vagaries of father time. Dotson's experience as a starter at right tackle in the league should be of great comfort to Broncos country. With the turnstile the Broncos have had at right tackle since even before Super Bowl 50's triumph, fans have developed a little PTSD and will rightly be skeptical of Dotson until he proves himself in the pudding. Dotson, 6'9", 315 pounds, is coming off a final year in Tampa in which he started 15 games at right tackle, earning a 71.0 grade from Pro Football Focus. Dotson's grades easily trump what Elijah Wilkinson produced in his 12 starts last year in relief of the injured James. As a starter, Dotson has produced six seasons with a grade of 70 or higher, according to PFF. Meanwhile, Wilkinson earned a 59.6 cumulative grade last year, ranking him 59th among qualifying tackles. The fly in the ointment with Dotson is the penalties, which is another reason fans will remain a little skeptical, thanks to the recidivist face-palming fouls by Garrett Bowles over the last 3 years. Although Dotson graded out far better than Wilkinson last year, he was penalized a whopping 10 times. 5 false starts, 5 holding, which, combined with his age, is the big reason why he languished on the free agent market for 6 months. For comparison's sake, Wilkinson was flagged 6 times, which is still a lot. For now, Wilkinson will likely continue as the leader in the clubhouse for the first team right tackle duties, but the Broncos would be remiss to not rotate Dotson into the mix and allow the two to compete. I would expect that by the time the Broncos get to August 14th and training camp really kicks into high gear, Wilkinson and Dotson will be rotating in with the first-team offense. Under the expert and discerning eye of venerated O-line coach Mike Munchak, surely the best man will win. I'd favor Wilkinson slightly as the favorite, but only because of his incumbency and familiarity to Munchak and the team. However, Wilkinson is still very much a newbie when it comes to starting at right tackle in the league, and there's a really good chance Dotson will step in and make apparent his veteran experience. The NFL is the ultimate meritocracy. If Dotson shows better competency, he'll win the job. However, if it's unclear, or if there simply aren't enough quality reps to be had for the coaches to make a decision, especially in light of the preseason being canceled, the Broncos could roll into 2020 with Wilkinson as the starter. But if that's how it shakes out, no question, the Broncos have experienced depth at the position, which is something the team couldn't say even a few hours ago. For Mile High Huddle and Sports Illustrated, I'm Chad Jensen.